Alléluia, alléluia. Glory, glory, glory be the name of the Lord. Oh, the glory must be to the Lord. Can we worship the Lord? For he is worthy of our praise, no man on earth should give glory to himself. All the glory must be to the Lord. For God has made us to see another Sunday. Let's lift up our voice and glorify the name of the Lord. For everything in our life from January is only Him. Only God Himself deserves our glory. Beloved, congratulations. Because you have seen another Christmas again. You have seen another year already. 2022 is already here. I want us to take a few minutes now to reflect on our past. How God has been gracious to me and to you. Beloved, if you are not where you wanted to be, I thank God for your life that you are not where you used to be in 2020. And I know God is still working on you. So, please, thank God that makes you to be alive today. I want us to worship the Lord in our spirit. Let something just trigger your joy and happiness. It doesn't matter your situation today. Just lift up your hands and glorify the name of the Lord that you are still alive. Beloved, there are many reasons why we should give thanks to the Lord. I personally, in February this year, I had a very terrible sick bed. Serious one. It wasn't an accident, no car accident. I was just in my house. And as I was playing with my boy, my feet slept or whatever. And before I can say Jack Robinson, I find myself in ICU with brain concussion. Many people have died just like that. Doctor didn't do anything. They say I have to come back on my own. Less than 24 hours or 24 hours, and I came back on my own. Doctor said, no, you might lose your memory, many things, short memory, long-term memory. You know what I'm talking about, medical practitioner, or you know somebody that this has happened to, and they are gone. Or some are not human, they are no longer human beings. So why won't I give praise to the Lord for making me to see the last Sunday of this year already, for making me to see 2022, for making me to see yet another 53, another 60 years? I want you to lift up your voice wherever you are. And God brought me out from the spirit of death. No man pray for me, no gymnastic, but the grace speak for me. I'm a living testimony that death is defeated and can be defeated without any gimmicks. That's why I lift up my voice this morning to say, Lord, I thank you. My mouth and my ear are not enough to give you praise for making me to see 2021, 2022. The beginning of 2021, the end of 2021, That's why I want you to bow down your head and lift up your voice wherever you are watching me this moment. God has got something for you. Something, one thing, one thing. It doesn't matter how many things he has not done. If he has done one thing, he can do many things. He's waiting for you to be appreciative. And part of the things we're going to be discussing this one is going to lead you more into appreciating God in your life. Remember, we are in our month of total release, our month of compensation. I want you to look at your past. Where have you been head up or where have you been head down? It's time for you to release yourself. So many people are under ungrateful prison. I just want you to lift up your voice to glorify the name of the Lord. Marizuzaha Katalia Gravabosh. Lord, I am grateful to you for me and my family. And for the bread and the sound of my voice that I'm grateful. We join our faith, O Lord, to worship you. We join our faith to glorify the name of the Lord. Holy Spirit, we thank you. Thank you, Spirit of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. As we are worshiping the Lord again, I want you to share this platform. I want you to invite somebody to be part of this platform. Because we are about to discuss something very important. It concerns everybody. And please, do yourself good to concentrate on this message this morning, or this afternoon, or this evening, whatever time you are hearing me. I want you to catch something that will change your life. Lord, we glorify your name. We bow down our head to worship you. Father, we are not the ungrateful one. We are very grateful to you. Thank you, Jesus. Let your name be glorified. We worship you. Please know that we don't have the right of ownership to all this worship song, but we believe it blesses our life, and we use them for this platform as our praise and worship section to complement our service. So we bless God for all these worshippers that have been using their music. Beloved, my name is Dr. Tao. And I'm the senior pastor of Worship at Our Ministry, the convener of Church in the House. If you are listening to me now, whatever medium or whatever time you are listening to me now, you are a member of Church in the House. And I want you to click the button on Church in the House, so that you always be informed when we are online. I want you to inform, send somebody a message that Pastor Dr. Tao is about to teach on a crucial topic of liberation. Title, Dealing with Your Ignorance for Your Total Freedom. Dealing with Your Ignorance for Your Total Freedom. Remember last week, we started discussion on, and we dealt with overcoming your confusion. Why are we treating all these topics this season? Because we are in the last days of the year, and we are evaluating, and we are assessing the year so far, spiritually, physically, medically, vocationally, professionally, maritally. We are examining our year, our month. Otherwise, if you fail to examine the year, you might be sleeping and dwelling in one error continually, and there may be no changes. And remember, 2021 is our year of a new life fulfillment. From 2021, we enter into new life fulfillment. There will be no new life fulfillment when you fail to reassess and reconsider or evaluate where you are coming from, where you are, and where you are going. So we want to evaluate where we are coming from, where we are, and where we are going again for 2021 as we are preparing our journey to 2022. So I want you to deal with this issue before you even begin to say Happy New Year or before you begin to say anything for the new year. We are preparing for the new year, people of the Lord, 2022. But let us examine 2021. How way, how far, brother, how market, 2021. How market? Market is good, market is bad. I'm going to show you something that will change your life. Because you can't keep doing the same thing 2020, 2021, 2019, 20,000, and you want to do the same thing 2022. You expect the new result. No! You are a dummy if you are in that category. God has sent me this morning to wake you up, to charge you to a new life fulfillment. And one of that issue, or one of the critical part of life to deal with in order to enjoy a new life fulfillment, I enter 2022, is to deal with your ignorance. Ignorance. There is nothing that keep any man in bondage of life or enslavement of life more than their ignorance. Ignorance. And who is an ignorant person is someone that suffers from ignorance. Let me take you back to the creation. Even Satan knows that the moment Adam and Eve brain awake and their eyes enlightened, he knew that Adam and Eve will be much more conscious. They will understand themselves. And we truly did happen. Because he came to open their eyes. Peradventure, God is keeping them in blindness or in ignorance for certain time. But Satan, understanding the purpose of light and enlightenment, and it is that light and enlightenment that Satan introduced to Adam and Eve that took them out of the garden. Positively, negatively, I want you to understand how your ignorance can affect you positively or can affect you negatively. I want us to look at this. It's a very crucial topic that it takes boldness of heart, or you are being sent by God to say some of these things that you are hearing from this altar. And you know why? God has liberated me from the religions of men or religions of years and took me into a new life of fulfillment, a life of reality, a life of practical realities of life. And that's what I know, that in this journey, it's too late for anybody to enslave me anymore. I am free from every spiritual enslavement or any otherwise enslavement. So I want to borrow you some kind of knowledge today on dealing with your own ignorance. If you want to get out of the of slavery mentality, you might be finding yourself, whether you are finding yourself in marital slavery, financial slavery, spiritual slavery, political slavery, economical slavery, whatever form of self-enslavement you find in yourself, there is a way out. And you will be out of it this morning or today in the mighty name of Jesus. If you want to, that is, if you are ready to listen and accept your ignorance. Beloved, lest I forget, Happy New Year in advance. We have already stepped into 2022. And Merry Christmas in advance. If we are able to come online for Christmas message, we will come online. Otherwise, please go and enjoy your holiday. Or stay in your house with your family and enjoy your Christmas holiday. Do something new. Whether you want to be at home this Christmas to meditate, whether you want to travel, do something new. But be very careful. Remember, the season we are is not the season of 5 years, 10 years ago. It's part of the thing we are going to discuss now. Dealing with your ignorance. How many people know that as you are hearing me now, you are swimming, you are living, you sleep, you eat, you dream in ignorance. Our ignorance may not be the same, but one way or the other, until somebody will tap you, that my friend, even a president can be swimming and dreaming in, and be walking in ignorance. How much more? So everybody, let's go into his issue. Romans chapter 1, verse 25. For are we not, brethren, that you should be ignorant of this mystery, lest you should be wise in your own conceits? That blindness, in part, is happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentile be come in. Lest you should be wise in your own conceit. Lest you be wise in your own idea when you are actually swimming in ignorance. I will not, brother, that you will be ignorant. Don't be an ignorant person. This is Apostle Paul. So he must have seen a lot of people. Follow people that are ignorant of what is happening around them. Are you ignorant of what is happening around you? Let's look at some of those ways. Moreover, First Corinthians chapter 10, verse 1. Say, moreover, brethren, I would not that you should be ignorant how that all our fathers were under the cloud and all pass through the sea. Do not be ignorant of our fathers' fantasy. Fathers. Political fathers. Spiritual fathers. Grandparent fathers. Oh, they were ignorant of the ignorance of the past. Or they are living in the ignorance of ideology. Listen to me. There is nothing that keeps any man in bondage of life or in the self-enslavement more than their ignorance. It is your level of ignorance that determines your level of freedom. The less ignorance you are, the more the freedom you be. The more ignorance you are, the deeper you are in your prison of life. So many people suffer today. Are you in any slavery today? Are you in any addiction or are you in any affectionate slavery? So many people are in affectionate slavery. They are in the slavery of what they love. It's going to free you. It's because it's what you love. And I always said it. If you love your chain, you will always kiss. If you love your prison, you will always kiss what? You always kiss your chain. Bamina? Even if anybody has put me into prison before, I have discovered myself. All round. I'm talking about all round. Spiritually, politically, my eyes has opened. I know which political party to vote for next year now. Or next time. Yeah, so many people are suffering today financially, materially, spiritually, professionally, not because they were uneducated. Are you hearing me? Not because they were uneducated, but because of their ignorance. So many people are suffering today not because they are stupid. Not many people are not stupid. They are intelligent. They are professors. They are doctors. There are learned people that are suffering in self-enslavement. Self-enslavement, not because they are uneducated, not because they are stupid, so to say, but their ignorance. Ignorance is actually a lesser form of stupidity. But without ignorance, there is no stupidity. And everyone that are stupid today, they started from ignorance. So before before you graduate from ignorance to stupidity, let me deliver myself from this ignorance. So, I see so many people that suffer today, spiritually. They are seated as I'm talking to you now in the church. You are seated, you are hearing me now, but you are suffering spiritually because of your ignorance. Thousands of thousands are in church today. They are in the temple today. Thousands of thousands are in a political party or political meeting today, or they will be tomorrow. Not because they are stupid, but they are suffering from ignorance. And that ignorance has kept them in total perpetual bondage. So, let's look at what are the facts about ignorance. How to deal with your... So you need to know facts about ignorance so that you know how to deal with your own ignorance, because everybody's ignorance are not the same. So many people, like I said, suffer undue self-affliction, addiction, or they suffer total shame due to their ignorance. Mark this down. Your ignorance is a tool, or your license, or it is your contract for your oppression and slavery. If you have signed for ignorance in your life, you have already signed anywhere for your oppression and for your slavery. Until you unsign that contract, you are bound in that self-suffering or self-enslavement. You may be in a total slavery of your friends, relatives, or higher power over you due to your ignorance. Is anybody controlling your life? Your boss? Any higher authority, your friends, your relatives, or any higher power that control you? You are the one that gave them license. Nobody can control your life until you personally gave them the license of your ignorance. Certificate, you have certificate of ignorance, and you sign it, contract of ignorance, and then you are getting what you are getting now. It's time for you to terminate that contract of ignorance and get your freedom. When someone suffers from self-ignorance, they are very quick to demonize self-imprisonment. They are quick to demonize self-suffering. They are quick to demonize poverty or backwardness. It is a demon! Let's go for deliverance. No. They are suffering for ignorance. When you are under a severe self-enslavement, you demonize everything. Because you look for left, you look for right. You can't even see that demon. You can't even see the witch that is pursuing you. But you keep saying it's the witch and wizard. But no, self-ignorance is your witches and wizard that is killing you and destroying you. Ignorance, your self-ignorance. So you go for mountain, you go for everywhere, you go for counseling, not knowing that it is your self-ignorance. So many people are backward today. They are in deep poverty because of their self-ignorance. Who shall deliver you? Only yourself will deliver you. Fact about ignorance. Ignorant person We never accept that they are ignorant. That's one fact I want you to know. Even as I'm speaking now, an ignorant person is saying, what's this one saying about? Let me cook. Let me watch Africa Magic or let me watch football. Ignorance. Because you will never believe that you are yourself in imprisonment of ignorance. That's why, particularly among the Christians, I believe Christians and non-Christians are hearing me now. Believers of one faith or the others. And the Bible says it. Let's look at Isaiah chapter 62. Isaiah chapter 42, verse 18 to 23. That's why the Bible says. He said, "Hear ye deaf, and look ye blind, that ye may see." No, but they will not hear, they will not see. Ignorant person. Verse 19. Who is blind but my servant, or deaf as my messenger that I sent? Who is blind as he that is perfect, and blind as the Lord's servant? See, verse 20, see many things, but thou observest not. Opening the ear, but he heareth not. They go to church every Sunday, every Monday. They hear me, but they heareth not. But what they want to hear is what they want to hear. They don't want to hear others. Who is as deaf and who is as blind? That is, the scripture is saying that who is as stupid, who is as ignorant like you and me, brethren? We have eyes, we cannot see. We are able, even when you hear, you just hear. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Ignorant people. And when they are out of church, their stupidity, their ignorance follow them. The next Sunday again, another dose of ignorance. We carry it. And then, before you know it, you are a man and woman of ignorance, as personalize your life. You see, the Bible says in verse 22, but this is a people, rob and spoil, ignorance people, because they cannot see, they cannot hear. They are all of them sneer in oaths, and they are hid in prison houses. It's not me that said it, it's Bible. They are for a prey and not delivered, for a spoil and none said restore. But now I am saying restore, if you care. You see, they are in their prison houses. They will leave church 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 5 p.m., 6 p.m., back to their houses, prison houses. They leave the work on Monday to Friday, back to their houses as prisoners of conscience. Prisoners of ignorance. You live your life daily in ignorance and you expect something new in your life. You are a joker. Please hear this. Check your ignorance life. Where are you living? Where are you missing it? That's why God is sending me this message to you. Hear me and hear me clearly. If not for the mandate of God, the new light of God upon my life, I would not also be sharing this word with you, because you know, no pastor will share this word with you because they are afraid of your tithe and your offering, or your, you won't call them papa or mama anymore. No, I would rather liberate you so that you will liberate other than putting you or putting thousands of ignorance people in one place. These are people rob and spoil. There are many of them in the political party, in the church today, in other place of worship. They are there. They are snared and they are hiding in prison houses. Lord, restore me. Somebody lift up your voice. Lord, restore me. Lord, restore me. Deliver me from this stupidity, ignorance. Verse 26 says, who among you will give ear to this? Who will aching and hear for the time to come? So, Lord, save me, Lord, deliver me. It's not by prayer only. It's by what? Obedience and by learning and by taking yourself away from your ignorance. Fact about ignorance. Ignorance is a disease. Hear it and write it down. Ignorance is a disease. It's like a cancer. If you don't treat it, it will eat eating up your system gradually, 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 until it's a blown, full-blown cancer. And it kills. It could be cancer. So you know cancer has different type. So it's like ignorance also is a cancer. It could be cancers of marriage, cancers of finances, cancer of lateness, delay. There are many cancers of ignorance that can hit your body up until you, and if you don't treat it one by one, you are dead already. You are just a living corpse. Ignorance is a disease that eating down and cut down life and cut down your destiny. Say, God forbid. Fact about ignorance. Even in the secular world, ignorance is a crime. Yes or no? Lawyers. You know, because why? Ignorance is not accepted in the court of law. My Lord, I am ignorant. Hey, you have given yourself what? You have condemned yourself. Ignorance is not accepted. Otherwise, everybody will say, no, my Lord, I didn't know. No, no, you don't know. You don't know is a crime. You don't know. And how would you know? Because you don't want to know. And when you know, you pretend you don't know. Ignorance is not accepted in the court of law. Even in the court of God, your ignorance. Adam say, oh my God, my Lord, it is the Satan that you, it is the woman that you gave to me. I am ignorant. Woman, you done this? Adam, you did this? Eve, you did this? Satan say, oh, you know, no. May I just try to enlighten them? You see, so there are some certain ignorance, there are some enlightenment that are positive and there are enlightenment that are negative. Yet, if you yourself decide to live in ignorance, you would code it. As I'm speaking out, to some people it's positive message, to some people it's negative message. You code it because I know your ignorance will not allow you to accept what I'm teaching you now. And I'm going to show you in a short while. Dealing with your ignorance for your total freedom. You will never see your slavery mentality, your slavery master to tell you that you are ignorant. No, he will never tell you. If you are following me stupidly, I will never speak this word to you in order to save you. No, I would rather be straightening you that you are a good son, so that I can keep, you know, Laban was cheating Jacob for many years because of his ignorance until he wake up from his brain. Where is your ignorance? Or how is he affecting you? I want to show you type of ignorance as we are still looking at characteristics of ignorance. Number one, self-perfection ignorance. When a man, or how do I know that I am under a acute ignorance. Begin to measure this one and begin to assess yourself. When a man is ignorant, he believes he is the best. And everything or she is doing is the best. And every other person correcting him or her, they are demonic. That's a man living under ignorance. He believes he is doing, he is the only perfectionist. Self-perfection. Or self-perfectionist. Every other person that is trying to correct him or correct her He sees them and he tags them as demonic. Christian. Number two. When you are under a severe or acute ignorance of life, you are under a third party manipulation. Particularly when men suffer from other men's power. This is the ignorance of the third party. When a man suffers from other men's power, manipulation, or superiority, your sovereignty, your ignorance, your sovereignty is due to your ignorance of your third party manipulation, because you cannot decode that this person is manipulating me because of your what? Of your superiority. Ignorance. You are so ignorant that to know that that woman is not there anymore. Ignorant, and you are crying and weeping. The man has performed, the woman has performed. The man is no more there, the woman is no more there, the business is no more there. So, a third party superiority. For example, let's go into the house of the Lord. You may be under a perpetual slavery due to your pastor's superiority, adoration. Pastor's superiority against church members or believers has made so many people under illusion, under total bondage, because you are ignorant. If you are not ignorant, how can somebody come from somewhere you don't even know? You are in America, somebody come from Africa, and he came to your church, and he started doing abakada, abakada, and you are falling to it, ignorant. Because that's this ignorance of your pastor superiority, or papa's, mama, founder's, geo superiority over your life. Manipulation of the third party. Another one is superiority adoration. You can suffer ignorance when you are under superiority adoration. It's different from third party manipulation. When you believe and you subject yourself to everything under a man, you suffer from self-manipulation. When you believe and subject yourself to everything under a man, you suffer self-ignorance. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we worship you. How does man suffer ignorance? Self-consolidation. When you believe you are doing everything right and every other person are doing or saying wrong things about your loved one, pastors, parents, friends, lovers, relatives, associates, you self-consolidate yourself. Instead of checking out the information, you self-consolidate yourself, then you might be living under ignorance. And that ignorance can take you a long time if it doesn't kill you. How do I know I'm under your ignorance? When you are a follow-follow, or when there is a, when you suffer from what is called follow-follow syndrome, it's a sign of a chronic ignorance. Follow-follow syndrome is a sign of a chronic ignorance. When you are yes sir, yes ma, yes sir, yes ma, follow-follow, you follow, everything papa say you follow, everything mama say you follow, everything the president say you follow, everything that, whether even when the president is right, is right, when the president is wrong, is right. You follow when you see the multitude going this day, you follow them. When the multitude going there, you follow them. Ignorance. Why are you running? When you ask some people, why are you running? I say, I don't know. I just saw people running. Ignorance. It's called follow syndrome. Everybody is doing this thing. You want to also do it. It's called follow syndrome. You suffer ignorance of things you don't know. And you pay for it dearly. Dealing with your ignorance for your total freedom. Let's quickly go more deeper into type of ignorance or characteristics of an ignorant person. How do you know you suffer from ignorance? Self-ignorance, number one, again. When you choose to believe what you want to believe and neglect others' point of view or correction, you suffer from what is called self-ignorance. That is what you call self-appraiser ignorance. Praising yourself. Praising yourself. Every small thing or every little thing, every small achievement, you praise yourself, not knowing that, is it bad to praise yourself? No, it's not bad, but praise yourself with dignity and with sense of mind. Not by thinking that you have arrived. Ignorance. I have arrived. And then you begin to misbehave. Self-ignorance. Not knowing that where you are, even right now, is nothing. We thank God for where you are, when you thank God for it. But when you begin to have arrogance in where you are, then you have given yourself self-appraiser and your ignorance of the others, some other people's achievement. When you have not seen somebody's achievement, then you will think you have seen achievement. And you have limited yourself to where you have pinned yourself down to your small achievement. You are suffering from ignorance. How do I know? Am I beyond that self-ignorance? Personality or role model or public idolatry. When you are a person or a man or a woman that follow public or role model or public figure, you worship them. You ignorance. Your spiritual mentor, idolatry. Your public figure, idolatry. Your social media figure, idolatry. You are ignorance. Because you don't know who is that man, you don't know who that woman is. Some people even to this point that they even put papa, mama, we have all done it before. Is it bad? I don't know. Well, just assess yourself. Ignorance. Somebody you don't even see in America or America, you put it on your screen and then you use as your DP. You say it's your role model. Ignorance. Some people will put that Michael Jackson or whatever, everybody, whatever name, whatever prophet, whatever. I don't want to know. But I just know that you are ignorance. How many times have you even put your wife, your son, your daughter, yourself, your business? People are looking for you. When people are looking for you in your picture, they find papa. They find mama. They say, no, this is not the person we are looking for. Ignorance of what? Spiritual, role model or public idolatry. This one, you will not want to hear it, but I will say it. Spiritual ignorance. That is when you are ignorance as an over-righteous, overconfidence, and when you are fully indoctrinated, you are under spiritual ignorance. Fully what? Indoctrinated. Overconfidence and over-righteousness. You don't want to see, you don't want to look yourself in the light of other people. You are the most righteous person. Because why? You have been fully indoctrinated with ideas. So there are many people that suffer under this spiritual ignorance because they suffer under under the logo rather than the rhema of the world. The letter killer, these people. The letter killer, because they only read the logo of the world, not the rhema of the world. Spiritual ignorance. Even 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 1 say, now concerning spiritual gift, brethren, I will not have you ignorant. How does that affect a lot of people? So many of them, they have faith ignorance. Faith ignorant or ignorance. Those one, they suffer ignorance, they suffer because they don't even know that they can exercise their faith. One, faith ignorance. They don't know that they can exercise their faith. Now, another set of people, they suffer because of faith obsession or faith addiction. Everything is faith. Hey, hey, we are having faith. We are, nobody says it's not good to have faith, but faith with action, faith appropriately can save you rather than put you in ignorance. We are having faith to conceive. We are going to the mountain and we are going to evangelism. Faith in everything. We agree faith is good, but you are ignorance of other things because your faith has crowded your face. Your faith has what? Crowded your face in ignorance to see immediate solution instead of going to other country or going to Papa Mountain. You are dead already. Another one is medical ignorance. When you ignore your welfare and your well-being, signs, vital signs of your body, you don't even monitor your body, you don't know your signs, you don't know when you are hungry, you don't know when you are sweating, you just ignore everything medically concerning yourself. And when most of these people, Christians suffer this medical ignorance because they leave everything or they left everything to be done by anointing oil, mantle, prophecy, prayer, fasting. They ignore every other medical advices or medical signs and they suffer for it and they die for it. Who shall deliver you unless you hear what I'm telling you now? Nobody says faith is not good. But faith that channeled negatively will affect your life negatively. It shows your ignorance. Another one, as I'm rounding up, association of political ignorance. There are many people that are suffering from political crisis today because of their political ignorance. Political leaders, they have ascribed themselves ignorantly to a wrong party. And they will never leave that party because they are not ready to see that there is no way in this political party. They suffered for the rest of their life or many parts of their life because they are in a wrong association. Ignorance. Association, political or professional association, they suffer from it. That's nothing bad in being a medical member association or religion association. But check how this organization, how is it affecting your life? If not, you are just staying there, you are ignorant member. You have certificate of ignorant membership. What all these enemies, these are all enemies of progress and sources of your slavery. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 38 says, but if any man be ignorant, let him be ignorant. Romans chapter 10, verse 3, for they be ignorant of God's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, they have not submitted themselves into the righteousness of God. So there are many people that under the ignorance of men than consciousness of God. How do I know? And how do I deliver myself from self-ignorance? There are many followers that follow dogmatically. You follow with no brain, with no check and balances. I'm rounding up because of our time. How can I save myself? 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. Wake up to smell the new coffee. if you are a Christian? Why living in the past? Why are you living in the past? It's your ignorance. Not yet. Is it not enough? If any man be in Christ, this is Bible says, therefore, if any man is in Christ, he's a new creation. Why is this seated in old creation or ideology doctrine? Be quick to leave the fast behind you if you want to save yourself and enter 2022 with a new life fulfillment. Number one. Or number two, take away your fear. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. For God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Begin to have a critical thinking of every situation, of every event around you. Then you will deliver yourself of ignorance. Take yourself away, take fear away from your life. And number three, by renewing your mind. How do you renew your mind? You need to unlearn the past in order to learn the new or the current. If you cannot unlearn the past, you cannot learn the new. And then stop compromising with the past and the new. No, they don't work together. You either leave the past and take the new, or you leave the new and dwell in your past. Stop compromising with the past, no matter how sweet it was or it is now. You can never deliver yourself from slavery when you still compromising with the past. Finally, Romans chapter 12, verse 2 say, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Be not be conformed. Do not conform with your ignorance, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Sound mind, oh Lord, give me this morning. Lift up your voice, wherever you are. The word is enough for the wise. There are things you pray for. You go to mountain, you sow seed, and all about this for. You don't need that. You just need to sit down from this moment now and think. Think the past, think the present. Ask yourself question. But why? Why am I actually doing this? For what reason? What have I achieved? Or what am I achieving? Drop the fantasy of that thing you are doing or that you have been doing. Face the reality of it. Challenge that thing one day. Challenge it today. Start by doing it today. Challenge that thing today. I don't want to give you an idea, but you come up with an idea. But that's when you are out of your ignorance. I've shared what God asked me to share with you. I leave you with the rest. Lord, help me. That's my prayer for you today. And my prayer for myself. Lord, help me. Deliver me. Help me to deliver myself. Beloved, God cannot deliver you. You have to deliver yourself. Because he said, I've given you sound mind. But if your sound mind has been corrupted, I've been suspended by whosoever, then you need it's yourself that will deliver yourself. And I pray that deliverance for you right now. As you are hearing me now, the word of the Lord will give you light. Light and understanding of his word will set you free, will deliver you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Merry Christmas in advance and Happy New Year in advance. Shalom. Amen.